Hey everyone, Johnny here. In this quick video, we're going to look at how to do quick distributions around other objects. So in this scene, we see we've got these trees that are also surrounded by groupings of rocks. And we're going to see how we can accomplish this with a pretty simple geometry node setup. Now to get started quickly on this project, I've used a couple of add-ons to make some objects. The first is the sapling generator, which you can find under Preferences, Add-ons, and type in the word sapling. Make sure you check Add Curve Sapling Tree Generator. Also, type in the word extra and make sure Add Mesh Extra Objects is enabled. This one will give you the rock generator. You can generate rocks by pressing Shift A and choosing Rock Generator. The sapling generator is under Curve, Sapling Tree Gen. I've created an assortment of rocks and put them in their own collection. I also created three trees and put them in their own collection. And finally, I've created a ground plane that I'll use to distribute these items. I'm going to go ahead and hide the trees and the rocks and get started with this grid. I'm going to add a geometry node tree. And the first thing we want to do is distribute our trees. We'll use a point distribute node and we'll use a point instance node. The point instance node will use a collection and we'll point this to our trees. Immediately, you'll see that the density is way too high, so we're going to go ahead and lower that to something like 0.1. Even that's still too high, so we'll continue to lower this until it gets to where we want. We'll go with that for now. Next, we want to bring back our plane into our geometry, so we're going to want to group the trees and the original group together. To do that, I'll use a join geometry node and take the original geometry and plug it in as well. In addition here, I'm going to choose to not use the whole collection. This way, at every point, I'm only getting one tree from the collection instead of all three. Next, we want to instance our rocks. I'm going to copy these two nodes and point this one to my rocks group instead of my tree group. I'll put this output in the geometry as well. But now, we need to decide where the rocks will be created. We want them to be clumped around the bottoms of the trees. So we need to use the geometry of the trees, which is coming out of this point instance node here, and use that to drive an attribute proximity node. The geometry input of the attribute proximity node is the place where you want the attributes you're creating to go. So in this case, that's our grid. So we don't want this to be hooked up to geometry there. We want it to be hooked up to our original grid. The target is the object you want to actually choose the proximity from. So this would be our trees. Then we want to find out the distance from our tree objects to the mesh. So we'll use this distance and we'll just call it D. Now in the point distribute node for the rocks, we're going to use D as our density. Immediately, you're going to see that the rocks are not clumped underneath the trees. The reason for this is that the distance is actually going in the wrong direction. The closer we are to the trees, the less the distance, so the less the density. We actually want to invert this distance attribute. One way to invert an attribute is with an attribute color ramp node. All we need to do to invert is just flip these handles. So now what's coming in at 0 is now 1, and what's going was 1 is now 0. We'll say to do this with attribute D, and then put it back in attribute D. If we ramp up the density, we should see rocks to start appearing underneath our trees. Now you may be wondering why this is only clumping around some trees and not others. The reason for this is that my grid is not very high density, so only the trees that are near a vertex are actually getting data. To solve this, I'm going to go ahead and add a mesh subdivide node to my grid. Now there's more points for it to go ahead and create this proximity. So here with some lighting and textures and a little bit of focal length blur, we come up with a pretty decent looking image. I hope this gives you some ideas on how you could distribute objects in your scene for a more realistic look. Thanks for tuning in for this quick tip. I hope it inspires you to do something awesome. Make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. I'll see you next time.